Now that we have matrix vector multiplication cleanly squared away, we're ready to introduce another operation, matrix-matrix multiplication. Matrix-matrix multiplication is probably the most important operation. As a matter of fact, later in this subsection you're going to see that all of the other operations that we've seen before are just special cases of matrix-matrix multiplication. To motivate matrix-matrix multiplication, what we're going to do is go back to the opener for this week. We're going to talk a little bit more about our weather prediction model. Recall that we had this table that predicted the weather for tomorrow based on what the weather was today. And one of the last questions we asked was how to compute the table that tells us how to predict the weather the day after tomorrow from the weather today. And we talked about how that was a matter of tracking how the unit basis vectors were transformed by multiplying by the transition matrix that takes a state vector from one day to the next. What we're going to now do is relate this to matrix-matrix multiplication. What we have is the state vector for the day after tomorrow. And what we argued earlier this week was that that was a matter of taking the transition matrix and multiplying it times the state vector that predicts tomorrow's weather. And that, in turn, was a matter of saying, look, take the state vector that predicts the weather for today, multiply it by the transition matrix that gives you the prediction for tomorrow, and then take the result of that and multiply it by the transition matrix, and now we get the prediction for the day after tomorrow. It shouldn't be too surprising that if we had a table that predicts the weather tomorrow from the weather today, we should similarly get a table that predicts the weather for the day after tomorrow from the weather today. And if there's a transition matrix that takes us from the state vector for today to the state vector for tomorrow, there should also be a transition matrix that takes us from today to the day after tomorrow. So what does that mean? We should be able to feed in a state vector for day zero, and we should be able to find a matrix that then takes that state vector to the prediction for the day after tomorrow. And the action of that matrix should be identical to first multiplying by this transition matrix P. We called this P earlier this week. And then taking the result of that and multiplying it by P as well. What we're going to see is that you can take these two matrices and from them construct this new matrix Q. And the operation that takes these two matrices into this new matrix that has the same net effect as first applying the first matrix and then applying the second matrix, that particular operation we are going to call matrix-matrix multiplication. Let's look at this differently one more time. What really is going on here is that we're applying some linear transformation to the vector x, and then we're taking the result of that and applying another linear transformation, which happens to just be the same linear transformation in this particular example. And what we're really doing is we're composing these two linear transformations. Again, in this particular case, we're composing the linear transformation with itself. What we're going to see now is that there's a new vector function, let's call it L sub q of x, that has the same net effect of first applying LP to x and then applying LP to the result of that. And the question, of course, is that actually a linear transformation? And if it is, then we know that there must be such a matrix Q. If matrix Q exists, then we've seen many times now how to actually compute the columns of that matrix. All you do is you feed in the unit basis vectors to come up with the columns. So in this particular case, we're feeding in the unit basis vector L sub 0, and out pops the first column of matrix Q. Similarly, we could compute the other columns of Q. In summary, this gives rise to some questions. The first question is LQ of X, which is defined as a composition of L of P with itself, a linear transformation? The more general question is, if you compose an arbitrary linear transformation with another linear transformation, Is that a linear transformation? And if it is, how are matrices A and B and C related, where A is the matrix that represents L sub A, B is the matrix that represents L sub B, and C is the matrix that represents this new linear transformation L sub C? So that's what we'll be talking about for the rest of the week.